Hey, thanks for joining us on this Monday night. We begin with a story about the case that Hennepin County is trying to pursue against Minnesota Trooper Ryan Londregan. He's accused of killing Ricky Cobb at a traffic stop last summer. Use of force experts often take center stage at any trial involving law enforcement officers, as the question is always raised whether the force is reasonable or not. But in this case, the county isn't going with a use of force expert, and that's where we want to hand it off to Lou Ragus.
Well, Janet, Hennepin County Attorney Mary Moriarty retained use of force expert Jeff Noble specifically to review this case last year. But now, Trooper Ryan Londregan's defense attorney says the expert didn't give prosecutors the answer they wanted to hear, and the defense paints a picture of Moriarty determined to charge Londregan no matter what.
In September, when the Hennepin County Attorney's Office began reviewing the shooting death of Ricky Cobb during a Minnesota State Patrol traffic stop, Mary Moriarty in a statement called the work of their use of force expert a critical part of the process. But when she charged Trooper Ryan Londregan with murder in January and was asked about the expert, she said this.
We determined through investigation that came after that statement that charges were appropriate without the use of an expert.
Now, Trooper Londregan's attorney Chris Maddle has revealed that the expert, Jeff Noble, told prosecutors in their initial meeting in October that Londregan's actions, shooting Ricky Cobb, were reasonable if he perceived his partner was in danger of death or great bodily harm by being dragged by Cobb's car. Noble is a former officer and national use of force expert. Ramsey County prosecutors used him in the trial of Geronimo Yanez, the former officer charged with manslaughter for shooting Philando Castile in a traffic stop. In that case, Noble testified that Yanez's actions were unreasonable, but the jury disagreed, acquitting Yanez. In the Londregan case, Maddle has pulled several excerpts from a prosecutor's summary of their meeting with Noble, including, quote, Mr. Noble opined that in this case, a reasonable officer in Trooper Londregan's position would have viewed the threat to Trooper Seide to be real. Mr. Noble stated the danger was not hypothetical.
Is it a big deal that the prosecution had a use of force expert and that expert did not see that there was a crime committed?
That's huge.
Attorney Mike Brandt, who's not affiliated with this case, reviewed all the new documents for legal analysis.
At least from the pleadings in the case, it looks like they got to the point where the expert said, no, this was reasonable. And this was appropriate what this officer did. And that's what it looks like they pulled the plug and said, well, we're done with this particular expert.
A filing from the prosecution confirms that after the initial meeting, they stopped using Noble. In a statement in response to the developments, Moriarty's spokesperson emphasized that the meeting with Noble was just a preliminary discussion. Quote, the cherry-picked sentence excludes critical facts where the expert acknowledged information he would need to fully analyze the case. Specifically, the expert stated that he did not know the new use of force legal standard in Minnesota or how to interpret it, that he did not have a statement from Trooper Londregan, and that critical details related to Trooper Londregan's training were missing.
So why didn't they give him all that information and say, now does this change your opinion? But they're not going down that road.
At the trial, could the defense now call this use of force expert as their witness?
Absolutely. I would certainly want to call this particular person to ask them about what happened with the county attorney. What did the county attorney happen to say? And then when they got the opinion they didn't like that they cut off the conversation as a defense attorney, I would love to have that because it shows the government got the answer they didn't like.
All of this information is coming out now as part of a legal fight because Maddle accuses Moriarty of not providing all the documentation that the defense is entitled to when prosecutors have information that can help the defense. This will begin to be sorted out on March 21st. That's the next date that everyone will be back in court. Jana.
That kind of goes to my question, Lou. Is it normal for these things to be argued basically out in public? Shouldn't all of this wait till the trial?
It's actually pretty normal to litigate things so that we know when we get to trial what the rules will be, what can be used in the trial. So not that abnormal.
Okay, thanks so much, Lou. Appreciate it.